We're going to do a little test together. Take a look at this image and tell me what you see. Okay, and now this one. This one. And this one. This is an inkblot test, similar to the famous Rorschach test designed by Swiss psychologist Hermann Rorschach in the 1920s. It's been used since 1939 to examine your personality by looking at what you associate with these random inkblots. So when I look at them, I see a masquerade mask, two people surrounded by an evil leg-eating fish, a leaf, and a clown face. But we haven't only tested these images with people. Recently, Google researchers showed these images to four different artificial intelligence systems. They labelled their participants Robot 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the robots all had quite different responses. In the first image, the robot saw a hook, barrette, art, and one said it was a Rorschach inkblot. In the second, a jigsaw puzzle, fleur-de-lis, a design, and a black ink splotch illustration. In the third, a mask, pin, isolated, and another Rorschach inkblot. And in the fourth image, a hook, handlebar moustache, a print, and a black face paint print. So if a machine can understand and independently answer a personality test, can computers have personalities? The term robot was coined by Czech playwright Karol Kapik in his 1920 play Rossum's Universal Robots. Typically, the word makes people think of a metal-clad machine with blinking lights and a monotone voice, or a modern version of that. But robots include machines that dispose of bombs, perform delicate surgeries, and virtual software agents, what we also call artificial intelligence or AI. In his 1950 paper, Computing Machinery and Intelligence, Alan Turing proposed a test called the imitation game, where a human examiner would listen to a conversation between another human and a machine. If the examiner can't tell who is human or machine, the machine wins the imitation game. It's artificially intelligent. That test is now widely known as the Turing test. A strength of the Turing test is that it's really simple. It doesn't matter how we define intelligence, the examiner sits there and decides who is human and who is machine. And it's still considered a milestone in artificial intelligence. In contrast, the Rorschach test is pretty out of date. A big part of the test involves you explaining why you see what you see. And then an examiner uses a scoring system to tell you what that says about your personality. But studies have shown that it's neither reliable nor valid. Really, the Rorschach test is better described as a problem-solving task that gives you some indication about your past or future behaviours, or at least some of your thoughts. And the fact that mechanical brains can have unique thoughts, enough to distinguish responses in a task like this, is pretty cool. It does set them apart in some way, but is it personality? Personality can be defined as the unique psychological qualities of an individual that influence a variety of characteristic behaviour patterns across different situations and over time. But how does it apply to robots? In his collection of stories, I, Robot, Isaac Asimov introduced robopsychology as the study of the personalities of intelligent machines. It started out as fantasy, but Heather Knight, a roboticist from Carnegie Mellon University, argues that robots need personality so we can achieve things with machines that neither of us could do alone. And earlier this year, Google patented a method to download and customize personality to a robot. But what does a robot personality look like? In humans, our personality traits are our thoughts, feelings, and behaviors that distinguish us from each other. The five-factor model of personality suggests your traits are organized in terms of five broad factors. Research indicates these traits are present from a young age, come from both nature and nurture, and can change throughout your life. The plasticity principle suggests that personality is an open system that can be influenced by your environment. Research suggests that change is more likely at certain ages or life stages, think 20 to 40 or when you become a parent. We tend to think of robot personality like we think of human personality, that everyone's different based on your makeup and experiences. After all, those different AI saw different things in the inkblot test. But if one AI, like Apple's Siri, has millions of interactions every day, what does that mean for its personality? Siri, do you have a personality?
I can't answer that.
Let me know what you think in the comments. And see you next week. And if you don't already, subscribe to BrainCraft for a new brainy video every week.